Now, what we are doing? Lightning data services. These lightning data services are generally called as LDS. Lightning data services, generally called as LDS. Now, what is this lightning data services and why we are going to use this? What is this lightning data services? Why it is used? Right. Generally, if you are making any DML operation, I want to insert a record. I had a lightning component. Name. This is the component what I had. I entered the data like Wipro. Click on save. The moment you click on the save, what happens? It is going to call client side control. It is going to call client side, where client side controller is going to call some function. Then this is going to invoke server side control. Server side control, where when I call the server side controller, it goes to the Apex class. In the Apex class, we have a method called create, which will take string name, parameter is going to take, then it is going to create a record. So if you want to make any DML operation on the data, where are you performing? If you are trying to perform the DML operation, where you are trying to perform? On the server side controller. Am I right or wrong? If you want to make any DML operation, we are performing the DML operation on the server side controller. So if I want to create a record, insert a record, update a record, delete a record, what I was doing is from component going to the client side controller. Client side controller is calling server side controller, and in the server side we are performing the DML operation and giving the response back to the page. This is a regular structure what we follow. Regular structure what we want to follow. It is just like what we are doing with Visual Force. Now look at this. We have a Visual Force page. We have a Visual Force. I am just trying to compare with the VF pages so that you understand the concept easily. And you know what need to be replaced in the Lightning in place of Visual Force. So we have a VF page. Now I have given control equal to example class. Control equal to example means name of the Apex. So here I had name, phone, the moment you click on the save, what is happening? Request is going to Apex class. In the Apex class, we are making a DML operation. So VF is calling the Apex class, where in the Apex class we are making a DML operation of insert ACC. So from the client side I entered the data. When I clicked on the save, it went to the Apex class. In the Apex class, we performed the DML operation, saved the record, and response came back to the page. This is a general criteria what we want to perform. The same thing I can skip. The same thing I can skip and implement with a concept called Everett, this is a standard concept. Now, can I define a VF page like this also? Now, look at the VF page what I have given. I have given a VF page. VF page where I told standard controller account. Standard controller account, Apex form, command button, value equal to save. Action equal to save. I give input field, value equal to Apex input field, value equal to now. If I want to insert the data, now is it necessary that I have to go for a server side? Now, can I insert the data straight away from VF page? Why? Standard control equal to account. When I say save, the save method from account will be called and this record will be saved to database. Am I right? Now, is it looking for an Apex side controller? Apex side controller is not required in this case because when you define standard controller equal to account and when I say save, record will be directly saved to the object. The similarly, in the Lightning also, I want to perform the same. I don't want to interact with the server. Without interacting with the Apex class, I want to save the record. Now in the VF page, how the record is getting saved without interacting with the Apex class? In the same way, I want to save the record without interacting with the Apex class in the Lightning. To do this, we require Lightning Data Services. So can I say it is a counterpart of Lightning Data Services, a counterpart of standard controller. In the VF page, you are using a standard controller. In the Lightning, we are calling as a Lightning Data Services. Are you getting my point? It's one of the requirement. One of the example. Okay. It's not only purely, this is not only the concept. One of the concept for the initial classes. I hope you are good. You got my point? Now, if I use the Lightning Data Services without interacting with the server, I can directly save the record, update the record, delete the record. I hope you got my point. Everyone is good with this. So as of now, I can say it, Lightning Data Service is a counterpart of standard controller in the VF page. Whatever the role of standard controller is doing in the VF page, same role we are implemented by the Lightning Data Services in the Lightning. First point. Still there are many more services. Okay. Now let us see the next one. Now I have a page like this. In the page, I have component 1, component 2, component 3. Like this, we have. Now it is displaying a record. In the account object, we have a record name, now this is how we got. Now if you observe this, multiple components are trying to get the same data from database. This component is also writing a query, select name rating from account. Where name equal to Vipro. This component is also writing a SQL query, select name rating from account, where name equal to Vipro. This component is also writing the same query. This component is also writing a same query. So we have multiple components trying to fetch the same record or same data. Now we have multiple components trying to fetch same record from the database. Then why should I write so many SQL queries? Because every component is independent. Every component is independent. They will be writing their own SQL queries to get the corresponding data. But here the point is, all these components are writing the same SQL query. Now component 1, 2, 3, 4, all the 4 components are trying to get same data from the same object. Then why should I make 4 SQL queries? So the Lightning Data Service, what it will do? First identify what data they are trying to query, what data they are trying to query. Component 3, what data you want. Component 4, what data you want. Then identify, now whatever the common data we are trying to retrieve, they will make that single query. So that the number of interactions with the server will be reduced. If I make any change on this component, automatically the change will be updated to rest of the components, because the Lightning Data Service maintain a common cache. Now all the requests that what you are making will go to the cache. They'll simplify the query. Common queries are simplified and the data is fetched and the data is stored in the cache. Now whoever want to use, they come to cache and use it. Are you getting my point? Now Lightning Data Services, what it does? Now identify what data you are trying to fetch. If any duplicate queries are there, they simplify it, make a request to the server, get the data, put in a cache. All the components which want this data will come to cache, collect the data and display. So what it is trying to do basically, trying to avoid number of interactions with the server. Trying to avoid number of interactions with the server. Right. So at this level, we can give a straight away definition as what is the purpose of Lightning Data Services. It is used to load, that is fetch the data. Load the record, edit the record, delete the record, update the record, okay, from the component without interacting with the server side FX class. Okay, now when you are going for a Visual 4 page, I told you, if you use Visual 4 page with a standard controller, it will obey user context. The Visual 4 page will never run on the system context, always it runs on the user context. Unless you are printing any variables from FX class. See, if I write any controller, create a variable, trying to print, it will print. Because variable is not object. Account ACC, ACC is not object now. It is a variable of the class. Now, if you are trying to run any Visual 4 page will be running in the form of what? User context. What do you mean by user context? User's profile, user's OWD, user's sharing rule, user's field level security, everything is taken into account based on which they are going to run. Similarly, Lightning Data Service also will obey user context. So your profiles, your sharing rules, field level security is taken into consideration while running the operation. Now what is the advantage of it? What is the advantage of it? Because we are avoiding the server side interaction, operation will run faster. Performance will be improved. I hope you are good with this. Right. So let me give you the basic points here. Load, create. Data from the S object without interacting class. LDS will obey LDS will obey LDS will run as user context. user context means users OWD CPD is taken into consideration. While performing the operation, LDS will behave like standard controller, the VSH. LDS has strong cache, which will avoid number of calls to server side for the same set of data. Right, operation. Can perform loading the record. Creating a record. Shaping the record. Reading a record. Now, when you want to perform this, first we'll understand how this will happen. Now, first we'll start with loading the record. Everyone, listen carefully, boss. Very basic points. Listen very carefully. First, I'll start with the VF page. Understand the points. I'll go over to Lightning. Generally, in the VF page, I have like this. I'm opening a page like this. Salesforce.com/ This is how some ID is given. Now I have given Apex page, standard control equal to count. Now I have given some phone.name. Can I give it like this? Because standard control is account, I can refer with account name, account phone, account address. Then also I have given Apex detail. Related ID or ID. That's ID, I guess. Okay. I give current page ID. Okay. So I need to give $currentPage.okay parameters.id. So whatever the ID is given on the top, the same ID I'm printing here. Now when I give this, what will happen? First, this page is loading based on this ID. If that ID is not there, will I get name, phone, industry values? No. If that ID is not there, will I get this detail page? If you want to print the detail page, we need to know which record detail page I want to print. If you don't give me the ID of the record, I cannot print the detail page of the record. How the detail page of the record will open? Salesforce.com/ID of the record will give me detail page of a record. Am I right or wrong? If you want to open any detail page of a record, it is Salesforce.com/ID of the record. If I give, I will get the detail page of the record. Now, how are you getting this ID? Whichever the ID we are passing in the URL, same ID I am using in the page. So, the entire operation of this standard controller will not work if I don't give ID. Am I right? If I don't give ID, what happened? Account.name, name blank, phone blank, industry blank. Because you are not telling me which record data I have to print. Because you are not telling me which record data you have to print. If you tell me which record data I have to print, then I will take care about it. But you have not told me which record ID I have to print, so it will not run. Right? Same concept when you want to run in the Lightning also. We want to update a record. Which record you want to update? You want to delete a record. Which record you want to delete? You want to save a record. Which record you want to save it? So if you don't pass me the ID of the record, it will not, I cannot run this operation. LDS will run. Saving of a record or updating of a record or deleting of a record can happen only if you mention me the ID. So I have to tell to the Lightning, boss, if you want to load this component, ID is a must. If ID is not there, don't load this. If ID is not there, don't load this. Are you getting my point? If ID is not there, don't load this. How can you make ensure that? How can you ensure that ID is passed in the Lightning component? For this, we are giving a component called force hashed. So we are supposed to implement an interface called force has record ID. If a component is implementing this force has record ID, if a component is implementing an interface called force has record ID, then that component will ensure that ID is passed in the URL. If ID is not passed, it will not run. It says error. So to make sure that ID is passed in the URL, I have to implement an interface called force has record ID. This will refer to the ID of the record which is there in the URL. If it is not there, the component goes error. First question is completed. I hope you are good with this. Okay. Next, second point. Now, have you seen the concept of extensions? What is the concept of extension? If I want to override any one of the button in the objects, like a save button, cancel button, edit button, I want to override. Then what will you do? Object on which you are trying to override, that object is a standard controller and extension we are defining. Then only I can override it. Similarly, if this component has to get an ID, if you want this component to get an ID in the URL, now this should be added to the record of any, okay, it should be added to any one of the record, detail page of any one of the record. This component I want to add on the detail page of any one of the record. If I want to add this component on any one of the record, record means what? Any one of the record in the object. I want this component to be added on the record of any one of the object. On every record, on the record I want to add this component. If you want this component to be available, then I have to say flex page available for record home page. There is a interface, one more interface called flex page available for record home page. So if these two interfaces are implemented, then this component can be added on the record page. Second, okay, it ensures that ID is there. Now this component is added on the record page. Let me give you, boss. Look at the point, everyone. I have used a controller. I'm just comparing with the existing Visual Force in Apex so that you get an easy comparison. Okay. Now, in the extension, you have given Apex pages dot standard controller. Right? Am I right? So here, what I can do? Controller dot get. How this ID is coming? In whichever the record this button is added, on whichever the record this button is added, custom button, that record ID will be coming. Am I right? If I create a custom button, add it to a standard page, whichever the record on which the button is added, whichever the record from where I am clicking the button, that record ID will be passed. Similarly, when you add this component, from whichever the component, from whichever the record you are performing an event on this component, that record ID will come to this. If I add this component to a home page of a records, now whichever the record from where you are performing the events, that record ID will be passed to this as has record ID. Are you clear? So what are the 2 points we had? Has record ID. What is the purpose of this? It will ensure that you are passing the ID of a record. Okay. Flexi page available for record home page. It will ensure that this component can be added to any one of the record detail page. I hope you are clear with this. Am I clear? Okay. Let me give you this. First, let me show one example for you. Lightning component. Now here, look at this. Lightning record and a lightning page. These two checkboxes are implemented. These are interfaces. Then look at this interface, what we got. Flexi page available for all page types. So I don't require all page types actually. One is enough for me. This will do. I can type it also. Flexi page available for record home. Has these two interfaces. If I have these two interfaces, a component is created with available for record home, right? So what I'm doing, go back to this. Open any one of the record. It's a lead. Then I opened any one of the record. Here what we have. Now what are you finding here? Edit page, edit. Click on edit page. It's like a page layout. Now what happened? Lightning app builder will open. Lightning app builder will open. It will take some time to load the components. Let all the components be loaded successfully first. Now everything is loaded. Now scroll down. When you scroll down, you will find. Now we are finding the, here the components will be coming here. So whatever the components you have created, that components will be coming here. Whatever the components you created, that components will be coming here. Whatever the components you are creating, that component will be available here. So if I want this component to be available, then I have to say flexi page available for record, flexi page available for record home page. Now go back. Okay. So if it is available, then I can take the component and add it to the. Now still we are not done the record data types. Once you are done, we'll be finding the components here. Then what I can do, drag and drop that component and put it whatever the location you want. Drag and drop and put whatever the location you want. Are you getting my point here? So let us come back again. I'll go back here. Go to account. What I'm doing, click on settings, record edit page. Then whatever the custom components we created, they'll be coming here. That I'll be putting here. Are you getting my point? So to make that component available here first, you're supposed to go for flexi page available for record home page. Is the first question is clear? Okay. Then let's go to the next. Now, whichever the record that is referred by this, now that ID is referred, right? Now, how do you get the database on that? whichever the ID we are passing, that based on the ID, we are supposed to get the record. Whichever the ID that ID is given on the URL, that record data I want to fetch. Then to fetch the data, we have a component. What is the component called? Force record data. What is the component we had? Force record data. Force record data. Listen, everyone. First one. How this component is referred? Your ID equal to, I am giving some ID. So that if I want to refer to this component using a controller, I say component dot find record. That is the reason I gave ID. Then I told record ID. Whichever the ID is given in the URL, whichever the ID is given in the URL, that ID will be stored here. So that I am assigning to some variable called v dot record. So look at the point. Whichever the record this is referring, whichever the ID of the record it is referring, that is stored here. That I am assigning to what? V dot record ID. Then we have layout. Now there will be two types of layout: compact layout or full layout. Now, do you want to refer every field of the compact layout, or do you want to refer to the every field of full layout? So I am giving layout type full. So every field of detail page I want to get. So what is a compact layout? On the top and detail page. Are you referring to every field of compact layout or a full layout? But it is not suggested to go through the page layouts, because time to time we keep on changing the things in the page layout. Okay, and multiple page layouts may be available for a single record. A single object may have multiple page layouts. So it is not suggestible to go for a layout type. Rather, it is better to go for fields. So if you want to refer to a specific fields, instead of saying a layout type, when it's a layout type, fields of the layout will be referred, every field in the layout. But I'm not sure which fields are there, because time to time the layouts will be changed. That is the reason it is better to mention the name of the fields. Fields name, phone name. So either I can take a layout type or fields, any one is sufficient. Both are not required. Either you say layout type equal to full or a compact, or give fields equal to so and so. Any one will do the requirement. Both are not necessary. Either you can define fields or you can define layout. Next, target record. What is target record? Based on this ID, whichever, okay, based on this ID, these fields are queried. Based on that ID, these fields are queried. Select ID, comma, name, comma, phone, comma, rating from account where ID equal to V dot record ID. Okay, then we are getting that record. Where is that record stored? Target record, which I am assigning to a attribute called V dot. Now, when you go for a target record, the simplified version of this target record is target fields. Simplified version. I will tell you why it is simplified. Now, when you are fetching, there may be a possibility of an error. Then, target. Now tell me what are the attributes we have. ID of the component, record ID which we are fetching from URL, layout type, which fields you want to refer, all the fields are compact fields. No, I don't want to use a layout type, I want to specifically get couple of fields, you can mention them. Target record, the record which you are fetching. Once I give the fields, the query will be running and the corresponding record will be coming, which we are calling as target record. Target fields, which is a simplified version of the target record. Target error, in case of any errors generated while loading, that we can find out from here. That we can find out from here. Okay. I hope you are clear with this. For this, what I was supposed to do, boss? First, I was supposed to create attribute name equal to record ID. Because I told V dot, right? All of them are attributes. చెప్పండి సార్. హలో సో వాట్ హ్యాపెండ్? Object, then we are getting era name equal to now this is the concept of loading the record. Now this is the concept of loading the record. Now, whichever the ID of the record you have given in the URL, based on that ID, we fetch the record and we are storing that record to the attribute. Once it is stored to the attribute, what I can do was, once it is stored to the attribute, what I can do? I can display it. How can you display it? Lightning card icon name. Standard account, standard colon account, title, then I have div, class equal to SLDS, padding, then I'm going for a paragraph. Here I can print lightning input value equal to label equal to name value equal to, look at the point, v dot. What is the name of the target fields? New ACC dot giving a class equal to SLDS P right. Now similarly, I'm going to define the other one. What are the fields I told? Name, rating. No component mark lightning, n spelling mistake, sixteen. What was that light? We have defined this. Now go back. Now, till here, anyone has any query? What was that? Record data, ID of the record which is passed in the URL, which fields you want to fetch based on the ID, record what we fetched. In case if there is any error, we are getting that error, which we are storing in attribute. This is a lightning card which will display name. Here, if I want to go for mode, edit, go back. So, accounts you have taken, go to the edit page. Why there's no component available here basically? Your component should be available here. Okay, let me check out. It should be available for the component there. Loading a record. Implements flexi available. Quick action we don't need because we are not creating any button there. So okay, let me do that one more time. No, it's a component, right? It's a component. I'm worried whether I'm writing the program in the same account or not. First, let me check. Because I've opened multiple ways. It's not getting reflected, means probably both the accounts are not same, I guess. Otherwise, it should be represented there. This account. It is not same account. I was writing a program in some other account and checking the changes in your account. Now let me close it. Maybe integration account I have added. Right, I have created this component and go back to this. Go to any specific record. Edit page. Scroll down. What are you finding here? Because I told available for record home. Flexi page available for record home. Then take this component, drag and drop. See this component, drag and drop. Activate. It'll ask you, do you want to run with the organization defaults? Now look at this. Where was our component? Record edit page. Component is not added here actually. Yes. Save. Activate. SN org defaults. Save. I didn't click on SN org defaults because LDS will be running on user context. What happened? Gini point cold ready. Now why we are getting this? Vice versa, I might have given here the component I have given phone. Label names I have given wrong. Rating. Go back here. Load the page. If you make any changes on the component, load it. So still not updated. Now based on the ID which is there on the top. So how are you getting Lightning? Or account object ID of the record. Whichever the record ID I am giving here, based on that ID, we are getting the data. Are you getting my point? So based on this ID, they are fetching the data and storing the data. Right. This is what? Loading the record. First we are done with loading the record. Once again, I will explain the loading of record. Okay. Then we will go for saving and updating the record. Are you clear about this? Okay. Now look at this. Here I have account, there was that rating, phone number is there, right? Okay. So I'll go with the detail page. Look at this cold, I modified into, right now it is cold, I modified into warm, saved. When he saved it, then what will happen here? When he saved it, the changes should be reflected here also. When he save it, whatever the changes I made here, that should be reflected there also. For that, we are going to go for saving the record, updating the record. Okay. So let us go back. I'll explain how to load the record one more time. Now get your queries clarified. If anyone has any queries, get them clarified from the beginning. First, we are having file, new, Lightning component. Right. Now I can say Lightning record page. Lightning record page, submit. Record page, will do it. Okay. When you say record page, flexi page available for record home. Force has record ID. Implements flexi page available for record home and has record ID. In this, what is the purpose of it? This will ensure that URL that we are passing ID in the URL. Right. Then flexi page available for record home. If you want this component to be added, to be added to detail page of any record, inside detail page I can say home page of any record, then we have to implement right. These two parts we have taken. Right. Next we had force colon record, force colon record data. What is the purpose of this force colon record data? What is the purpose of this? This component will refer to data. Whose ID is passed right? In this section, first attribute, we are going with URA ID. I can give anything of my choice, right? It's an ID. URA ID, we have seen number of times. Then we have taken record ID. What this will do? Record ID. This will refer to the ID of the record which is referred. ID of the, which is ID of the record which is passed in the URL. Then next we have layout type. You can say full or compact. This will specify which fields you want to refer. You want to refer. This will specify which fields you want to refer in the. This will specify which fields you want to refer in the. Okay, refer from the record. Possible values are. All fields on fields on. Then we had fields. This will specify name of the fields which you want to query. Note, we have to use either layout type or fields. Default one is fields. Sorry. Suggested is out of these two, anyone you can use, but what is the suggested one? Fields is suggested one. Then I am giving here target. Target record. So the record which was fetched based on the fields and the ID what we have given, that record is in target object. Target record. Target record which was fetched based on the record ID. Based on the record ID given, ready under the given field. Give it import up target fields. Simplified version of then we had then mode. This will specify in which mode we want to refer. Possible values are V1 edit. I hope you are good. Then caps. Right, boss. Default is view. So any query from this part? Everyone is good with this? If we want to implement one is force as already. Then, what was the next one that we had? Force record data. So, which I have given here. These are the given attributes. Right. So basically what we are doing, boss? I hope everyone is good with these properties. If you want this, I'll type it, otherwise we can go with the program directly. So you want me to do this or not? So most of you are home batch only, right? Only copying everything on notepad and putting home on it. So these are the properties what we mentioned. So this is the record data. Then next, how to display this data? We are supposed to display the data. So This is how we define. Now, for using this, we are supposed to define some attributes. Now, what are the attributes that are left out? Attributes. Attribute. Name. Type. Then we have target. Then we had era attribute name equal to So where we had target error. In case if any errors are generated, how you define? So here I need to give you few more additional points here. Target error. Now, if it is an error, then I want to print it. So we have if condition. How you define if condition? If there is any error, I want to print the message. But how do you check if condition? Now, how do you check if in the lightning? Now, Eura if, we have a component here, Eura if, I hope everyone, it is a simple one, I guess everyone follows this, I'm just copy pasting it. Now, what was this condition? Eura if it is true, what is true? I'm giving a condition. Era if, what is the condition? Empty. Empty what? If error is empty, there are no errors. If there is no error, error will be empty. When there is no error, no need to print this message. When there is an error, I want to print it. So what should I do? Not. Well, error is not empty. Well, error is not empty. Then print the message. What is the message you want to print? We can define your classes. This is what I'm giving. If the error is not empty, print the message. That is to check whether error is there or not. So here one extra attribute we have seen, extra component, that is okay, Eura if. Eura if is true. Else what should I give? Else I have to give as what? Right? In this context, we wrote require this else. I'm leaving it. If you want to else, we can do that. Okay. Now, I want to display. If you want to display, how do you refer to the, how to print the values of an element? Next concept is how to print the values. How to refer to the fields using target object. We are given target object. If we are given a target object, how do you refer it? So look at this. V dot target object dot fields dot field name. This is how we are supposed to give. So target object dot V dot target object dot fields dot field name dot value. Now this is a if you are going with target object. Now I told I told target field is a simplified version. I told target field is a simplified version. How do you refer? How to refer to target fields? Target field is V dot. This out, which is simplified version now. If it is a target object, V dot target object dot fields dot field name dot value. If it is a target fields dot what is our target field dot field name. That is the reason we try to use a target fields more often. I told that is the reason I told target field is a simplified version of target object. If you want to refer to the fields using target object, V dot target object name dot fields dot field name dot value. The same with the target fields, if you want to refer V dot target fields dot field name. Right. So which is more user friendly? The second one. That is the reason we are taking the second. Now, boss, always we are using fixed components, boss. Now let us go with some additional components. We are then using input, always using input, and last classes we have seen input fields, output text. But this time let us go with some better fields. So what I can use, let us go with the formatted data. This time we may go with the formatted data, because always we are using input text, input and all those input fields. This time let us use some formatted, just to get the new components added to this example. I can go with the lightning, formatted email, formatted location, formatted name, number, text. So how you display? Formatted text value. Formatted text value. Formatted text value. So if you go with the formatted phone, let's see. Formatted phone value. Formatted phone value. So I can go with this. I'm using here data. Now how you want to display the data? Lightning. Card, icon name, account title equal to V dot ACC record dot, whichever the record I'm referring, that record name I want to give as a title for the card. Then I want to display div. Apply the proper structure. If you apply the same class, gap will be same for every element. So what was that? SLDS. Horizontal. Then I'm going with so let me give you the same. Then in the paragraph, what I want to give? Lightning component. Then let me go with this. Lightning value equal to the same story, I will repeat it. Formatted text red boss. I hope any query in this. Still we are on the loading only. We didn't perform any calculation operations. Now what we are supposed to do? Go to the record. Still account record, right? Okay. Settings. Edit page. We scroll down. You are finding lightning. So I will try to remove this. Edit form. try to add fs2. Save it. What was this? Why you are getting this format? Because I told formatted. I hope you are good. Now you can also add labels before that. You can also add labels before that. So what was that? Right, boss? I hope you are good with this format. This is the concept of loading the record. This is the concept of loading. We just loaded the record. Then we want to go for saving the record. Let us see how to save the record. Now let us go to the next concept here. Save the record. Right. So let us go to the next concept. How do you save the record? If I want to save the record, it should be first in the edit mode. Only when it is in the edit mode, I can modify and save it. So if you want to save the record, we are supposed to understand some of the functionalities given by the LDS. So LDS has given in the LDS, we have a standard functionality. What was that? Save record. Let us look at the save record. Dot this is the method. This method will save the Now, if you want to go for a save the record, syntax of this method. Now, syntax. When you're going for the syntax, first we are supposed to understand few parameters. Try to understand. Here we are going to have component dot save. After saving the record, callback will be called. After saving the record, callback action will be called. So how you define a callback action? Callback action is callback action. Dollar a dot get callback. Dollar a dot get a callback action. In the callback action, so we define. So in the callback action, what we have performed, whatever the logic we want to write, the callback action will define function, save result. Should be defined in function, save result. So overall syntax is now overall how you define save record dollar a dot get callback get callback action action function function result just to understand I'm giving right parenthesis here. This is the way of writing logic. Save record dollar a dot get callback action function. So look at the structure everyone. So we're going to give get callback. So let me remove this action, you mentioned it. Get callback. Now look at this structure now. How you are defining save record dollar a dot get callback function save result. Now what will be there in the save result now? We are giving okay. Save record dollar a dot get callback function save result. Okay. What is there in the save result? It will contain the status. The save result will contain status. Now what is the status? Is it success or a draft? Success means operation completed perfectly. Draft means you are working in offline mode. In the Salesforce we can also work in offline mode. When you get online, whatever the changes you made, that will be synced. That is called a draft. Incomplete. Incomplete means for your account online, offline you are working, but it is not getting synced to online. You don't have that access. So the changes what you made in offline, they're not getting synced to online. So what is that? Incomplete. Error, there's a bug with this. And if any other reason, we are not sure. So that status will be there in save result. Save result will contain the status. What is that? Status is success, draft, incomplete, error, any other. Success means done. Draft means you're working in offline. You're working in offline. But once you got connected to internet, it will be synced. Incomplete means you are working in offline, but they are not going to sync to the net. Then we had error. I hope you are good with this. The format is clear. Work offline option is there. If you enable that, it will be stored to cache. Cookies. Right. Now this is the operation. So what was the next one? Save result. Operation. Let's see. I'll type it later, but already it's late. So we just give it. As of now, you understand all these points, right? Success, draft, incomplete. Now we also have get S object type. We also have get S object type. object API name, entity label, error, record ID, state. The state is what we are getting. Now, what is the ID of the record? What is the error message we received? Entity label, S object, label of the S object, object name. So this all will be there in a save record result. Okay. So let me go ahead with one example and finish this example. Now, what is our intention? We are going to modify the record that should be saved to database. So let me make it simple. Everyone has followed this example. So can I copy this example and modify input text? If you have followed this, I'll just make some changes on this example. If everyone has followed this example on the same component, I'll make some changes. Everyone has followed this example, right? Can I modify the same? Only what I'm modifying is output text I'm taking. I'm just giving 1, 2, 3, right? Okay. So here I was supposed to give mode equal to, then I'm giving here value equal to v dot then at the bottom I'm creating a button. Writing button. Value equal to on a click invoke. So what was that? URA input, not URA input, is lightning input. This is how I created. So what is the extra point I have created? One button. When I click on this button, control is called. So what is that controller here? Now, how do you refer to this record? Record data. How we can refer? ID is record. So I'm giving here. Component dot find. Component dot find record dot get. I can give it, or else why to write two statements? Let me fill it in a single statement. Component dot find, find the element dot save result. Save record. Then what I can do? A dot get callback. A dot get callback. Save record, within that get callback. Within the callback, what you are supposed to write? Function save result. So check the closing of the proper closing. Outer close. This one, this, okay, then properly save. Then what I'm doing, if save result dot state success or draft if draft console dot log record saved successful. Else if incomplete, unable to save, changes in offline mode. Else if save result dot state error no else dismiss anything apart from this unknown error. Now this callback will run after saving the record boss. When you say save record, record is saved. After saving the record, this is the message which are printing to get our operation, like after record is saved, I want to make some changes. That operation I am going to make in the callback. I hope you are good with this. I hope you are good with this one. So what we have done? Saving the record. We have saved the changes. After saving the record only, callback action is called. After saving the record only, callback action is called. So let us go back to this. Then what is the operation we are supposed to perform, boss? Go to the record again. Edit page, some old component was there. Let me remove that and add new component. So what is the extra point I have done? Component dot save record. That is the end of the game. After saving record, if you want to make any other action, that should be defined. First example when I showed, when I made a changes here, not reflected, right? Now we need to do it. Any point, rating warm. Hot. Save. Rating hot, saved. So go back to this, where is the rating here? So what was this? Now the rating was here, warm. Now I want to make here, it is still in the hot. Now I made a save. When I make a change here, it is automatically getting reflected here, right? Right, boss? So record is getting changed. Record is getting changed. I hope you are clear. Now what happened? When the record is loading, when I made a change here, right? Click on this and save this. When component is reloading, entire the changes should be applied in the this component also. Then I need to go for handler methods. Right now when change is happening here, it is getting changed to detail page. But what is our requirement? When this component is loading itself, when somebody make a modification on any other component, this component should also be reflected. Then I can go for handler methods. We'll see it in the coming classes. But this concept is clear for everyone. Everyone has followed this. So Lightning data services only we have seen save. Still there is a update and a delete operation, update operations and delete operation, multiple component communication. Still there is some concept with this. I hope you are clear about this concept. Everyone has followed. Everyone has followed. This is a replica of standard controller in the visual flow.